We want to simplify each expression only using positive exponents. In our first example, we have 3x to the second y to the third times 7x to the fourth y to the third. Because all this is being multiplied together, we could change the order and write the coefficients next to each other, the x's next to each other, and the y's next to each other. Or we could leave it in its current form and find the product of 3 and 7, then find the product of x to the second and x to the fourth, and then find the product of y to the third and y to the third. Let's go ahead and do that. So we'd have 3 times 7 times x to the second times x to the fourth, where if we're multiplying and the bases are the same, we add the exponents. That would be 2 plus 4. And then y to the third times y to the third would be y to the power of 3 plus 3. So this simplifies to 21 x to the sixth y to the sixth. Next we have 4 x to the fifth y to the third raised to the second power or squared. It's important to think of this 4 as 4 to the first power. So here we have powers raised to powers, so we multiply the exponents. So this would be equal to 4 to the power of 1 times 2, x to the power of 5 times 2, and y to the power of 3 times 2. So that would give us 4 to the second times x to the tenth times y to the sixth. But since 4 to the second is equal to 4 times 4 is 16, we should write this as 16 x to the tenth y to the sixth. Next we have 21 x to the sixth y to the third divided by 7 x to the fourth y to the seventh. So we'll first find 21 divided by 7, then x to the sixth divided by x to the fourth, and then finally y to the third divided by y to the seventh. So notice that 21 divided by 7 is 3, and then x to the sixth divided by x to the fourth would be x to the power of 6 minus 4. When dividing in the bases of the same, we subtract the exponents, and it's always the exponent of the numerator minus the exponent of the denominator. So then we have y to the power of, this would be 3 minus 7. So this would be 3 x to the second y to the power of negative 4. So while this is somewhat simplified, we should not have a negative exponent in our final answer. So to change the sign of the exponent on y, if we write this in fraction form by putting it over 1, if we move y to the negative 4 to the denominator, it would change the sign of the exponent. The 3 in the x to the second will stay in the numerator. Remember, the exponent on 3 would be positive 1. So this will simplify to 3x to the second divided by y to the fourth. And now for our last example, we have 2x to the power of negative 3, y to the fourth. This is not considered simplified again because the x has a negative exponent. So if we write this in fraction form as we did before, if we move the base of x to the denominator, it will change the sign of the exponent. Notice the exponent on 2 is positive 1, so that stays where it is. And the exponent on y is positive 4, so that also stays in the numerator. So this simplifies to 2y to the fourth in the numerator divided by x to the power of positive 3. Again, by moving this across the fraction bar, it changed the sign of the exponent. I hope you found this helpful.